Josh Moore, and I'm general manager.
I'm Ivan Zhang, I'm CTO.
So the problem that we are facing right now is that the United States is becoming more and more culturally and linguistically diverse as the number of international students studying abroad in the United States is increasing annually. And right now, only 20% of the American population can speak a foreign language or control the conversation in a second language, whereas over 56% of the rest of the world can hold a conversation in two or more languages every single day. So these international students that are coming across the seas to the United States are having a hard time integrating into the American cultural system, while the domestic students here are having a hard time finding outlets to practice their foreign language speaking skills. So our solution is Campus Language Connection. And we are an organization that uses an app to match these domestic and international students to help them increase their foreign language speaking proficiency, enhance their cross-cultural competency, and to expand their sense of community on campus through fun and relaxed face-to-face meetups with their peers.
So let's go to the product.
This is the app that we have in our meeting, and it's nearing the end. We have the homepage, which is upcoming events, which we're pulling data from all these different organizations across campus so that we're able to see different events and allow our users to get a chance to go and attend these events, increase their cultural competency. But more than this, just that, is our matching. And what we're doing here is we're allowing users to put in a language that they know, or languages that they know, as well as languages that, you know, that they want to learn and an interest. And from that, we're able to put them into specific groups of other people related to them that they can pick from. So So what we have here is a Tinder-like application where you're able to swipe right or left based on, you know, if you think this person matches you from the interests and the majors. And then after swiping right, you're able to get content, you're able to get their contact and be able to initiate that connection right away. Furthermore, we're going to do some more features in the future, and we're doing that by, one, Facebook, getting more data so we can provide better selections and groupings of these individual students. We're going to do geolocation so that we can make sure that when people meet up, they actually meet up, and we can provide that as value back to our universities. And finally, we're going to do curriculum development because we want the users to have a sense of progress. It's not just about, you know, meeting up and stuff. It's about being able to see where they're from, where they're at, where they end up.
So our markets are American universities and colleges, and the number of international students in the United States from 2014 to 2015 alone increased by over 10% to over 1.1 million students, and this number continues to grow annually. According to the National Census of Educational Statistics, there are over 3,000 U.S. universities and colleges with over 5% international students, and these are the schools that we are going to target. So our current competitors would be other language applications that will teach a language, such as Duolingo or Rosetta Stone, other language exchange applications such as Pandem or HelloTalk, and then other language classes or events that are occurring on campus. However, CLC differs from all of these because we are allowing students to meet up face-to-face, unlike most of these applications, to speak with a different person, make a new friend, expand their community in a very relaxed setting outside of the classroom, and to learn more about the world. Today, we have a pilot program established on Northwestern University's campus with over 300 participating members. We have them in three groups they will identify as globally interested or casual language learners, interested in cultural integration into the United States, or increasing foreign language proficiency for the job market. Over 70% of our users say that CLC has not only helped them increase their foreign language speaking proficiency, but has helped them better understand a different culture and has helped them expand their campus community through meeting new people. And over 90% of our users will say that CLC has greatly impacted and greatly added value to campus life.
So I'm going to talk a little bit about our market strategy. So we hope to be on 5 campuses by year's end. We hope to do that by first going to the international student offices and sell them on these statistics that we collected from Northwestern, that 90% of international students 70% feel like their cultural and linguistic competency is improved. And once we get a large cohort of international students, we'll go to the study abroad offices, we'll go to the language departments, and we'll match these international students with domestic students and create those linguistic and cultural connections. Once firmly established, we hope to be on 125 campuses by year 2020. Let's talk a little bit about our revenue now. So after talking with Northwestern and several of our mentors, we've identified that every university will pay about $10,000 in an annual subscription for a service like this. And so in year one, we're hoping to have two schools that are going to pay us, and then a gradual increase in our revenue until we have 125 schools in the year 2020, which equals about $1 million in revenue. So our milestones. So today, as I mentioned, our MVP is being developed, it's being finalized, and we have over 300 students who are already part of our pilot program. Within 12 months, we hope to have 5 active universities, 500 members that are using the app on a regular basis, and then also to have that fully developed app and all those future features that I've discussed. Lastly, within 30 months, we hope to have at least 30 schools and also 2,000 students using our app. So the ask. So right now, we are in the midst of, we have a solid idea, but we're still refining our financials, our go-to-market strategy, and how to incentivize students to use our app. So what we're looking for is we are looking for any kind of advisor or mentor to come help us and specifically help us in those areas of financials, incentivizing students, and our go-to-market strategy. Because we believe that with advice and mentorship, we can really turn this into the company and create some of that potential that we believe is there. So with that being said, thank you for your time, and we'd like to take the next 5 minutes for questions.
So right now you have 300 members. Are those active members, or what are they taking on as an active member? And you said that you're still building your MVP, but you already have members. So what are they using?
Yeah. So I established this program at Northwestern's campus in September, and these 300 members, we have 370 signed up, but 300 are actively participating. And actively participating means that they're responding to my emails, they're meeting up with their peers, they're participating in surveys that I send out, and they're coming to these big group meetups that I host, where the entire community can come together and just get to know people from different parts of campus, different parts of the world. And so now we have an MVP, but before this, I had been hand matching everybody. So everyone can go to our website, fill out a survey, and then I would take all of this data on a spreadsheet and match people one-to-one by hand. And we are turning this into an app because that was a very, very tedious process that needs to be automated a little bit if we're hoping to expand.
Why did you do that before? Did you get paid, or just
hand matching? No, I just love it. I think it's something that I had wanted on campus, and it didn't exist, and so I decided just to make it happen.
Have you looked at other revenue models, for example, advertising on the website or other ways you can pull in more revenue?
Yeah, so those
revenue
are
is pretty limited.
Right.
125 universities and
anything. Absolutely. Those are all things that we considered. We've talked with different mentors, and you know, we've explored advertising for people like that, and other mentor says no. So those are still like some of those nitty gritty details that we're still trying to figure out. We have the idea, we have the app, but we just want to figure out the best way to monetize.
And another potential revenue that we were thinking about would be registration fees for events from users. So if we had we could have people sponsor it, like Berlitz or events, or maybe they want to sponsor it, or we could have like a $2 or $3 fee for people coming into the event.
Yeah.
So why did you start with Northwestern?